For the third quarter in a row.
But Mr. Pulitzer, every paper circulation is down since the war ended.
Whoever said war is hell was not trying to sell papers.
What we could use is an exciting headline.
Well, what have we got today?
The trolley strike.
That's not exciting. That's epic.
It's boring. Folks want to know there's a trolley coming or ain't it? Nobody cares why.
And the strike is about to be settled. Governor Roosevelt is about to put his support behind the workers.
That man is a socialist.
Teddy Roosevelt is no socialist. He's an American hero.
The man wants to outlaw football for being too violent. Please, football, violent, you're right. He's no socialist. He's a communist.
Mr. Pulitzer, you must try to succeed.
Gentlemen, please, you are making Nunzio here nervous. And when Nunzio gets nervous, I don't look pretty.
You never liked Roosevelt. Wrote an editorial day after day against him when he ran for governor. And guess what? He still got elected.
Well, how am I supposed to influence voters if they're not reading my opinion?
Big photos attract readers.
Do you know what big photos cost?
But without flashy photos and big headlines, how can we sell more papers?
There's an answer right before your eyes. You're just not thinking this through, people. Nunzio knows when he's cutting my hair. Trim a bit here, and then trim a bit there. Just a modest adjustment can fatten the bottom line.
Mr. Pulitzer, please.
Shaping is tricky, the razor should float. Shave me too close and you may cut my throat. It's the simplest solution that bolster the bottom line.
But how does that help us sell more papers?
We don't sell papers, silly. The newsies sell papers.
I've got it. Right now, we charge the newsies 50 cents per 100 papers.
Yes.
But if we were to raise the price to 60 per 100...
Now you're getting somewhere.
A mere tenth of a penny per paper.
My thought exactly.
It would take the newsies 25 more papers just to make the same as always.
It's gonna be awfully rough on those children.
Nonsense. I'm giving them a real-life lesson in economics. I couldn't offer them a better education if they are my own. A week and I'll train them to be like an army that's marching to war. Proud of themselves and so grateful to me, they'll be begging to pay even more. When there's dirt on our shoes, boys, for God's sakes, relax. Why throw them out? All we need is some wax. Listen well to these barbershop lessons, but they'll see you through.
When you're stuck in the mockery,
comments.